Welcome to the PRU ICSSG Overview Training. During this module, we will introduce the PRU ICSSG. This is the next generation subsystem to the PRU ICSS, adding gigabit capabilities. We will also discuss at a high level the hardware differences between the PRU ICSS and the PRU ICSSG. And finally, we will look at examples of what new applications can be achieved with the PRU ICSSG. Let's start with the basics. What is the PRU ICSSG? The PRU ICSSG stands for Programmable Real-Time Unit and Industrial Communication Subsystem for gigabit speeds. As previously stated, this is the next generation subsystem to the PRU ICSS, building on the features and capabilities of that original subsystem. Similar to the PRU ICSS, PRU ICSSG is a low latency microcontroller subsystem that is included in a number of Texas Instruments processors and is efficient for low latency and I/O control. This subsystem has access to pins, events, and all system on chip or SoC resources, and can be used to implement fast real-time responses, specialized data handling operations, custom peripheral interfaces, and offloading tasks from other processor cores of the SoC. At the heart of each PRU ICSSG are four 32-bit RISC cores. We have two programmable real-time units, or PRUs, and two auxiliary PRU cores called RTU PRUs. In this training, we will be verbally referring to the RTU PRUs as simply RTUs. The main difference between the PRU and RTU cores is that the RTUs don't have any access to IOs. The RTUs are strictly available for data processing, while the PRUs can be used for IO control and/or data processing. The PRU ICSSG is divided into two halves called slice 0 and slice 1. These slices are 100% symmetrical. As shown in the figure on the slide, slice 0 contains RTU 0 and PRU 0, while slice 1 contains RTU 1 and PRU 1. Each PRU or RTU can operate either independently or in coordination with the ARM or the other PRU or RTU cores. This allows each PRU and RTU to be used for a different task or for the cores to be used in tandem for more advanced tasks. One thing to note is that the content of each slice can only be accessed by the RTU and/or PRU cores in that slice, while the content shown outside of the two slices are accessible by any core. The PRU ICSSG also offers a number of different memory types. Each PRU or RTU core has dedicated instruction and broadside RAM. The subsystem also contains data RAM 0 and 1 and shared RAM. The size of these memories varies between devices. However, data RAM 0 is typically used by PRU 0 and RTU 0, while data RAM 1 is typically used by PRU 1 and RTU 1. The shared RAM is accessible to all PRU and RTU cores. The PRU ICSSG also has an interrupt controller, or INTC, for monitoring and generating system events. This allows for both detection of peripheral events and communication with higher level software running on the ARM or with another PRU or RTU core. The INTC is a polling-based interrupt controller. The PRU ICSSG also adds a new accelerator that's not shown on the slide. This is called the Task Manager Accelerator, which enables preemption. Similar to the PRU ICSS, the PRU ICSSG has several integrated peripherals. By integrating the peripherals, the PRU read-write access latency is significantly reduced compared to external SoC-level peripherals. Lastly, the PRU ICSSG adds a number of integrated hardware accelerators. These accelerators assist with data processing or data movement and are useful to achieve both real-time and gigabit speeds. If you're familiar with the original PRU ICSS, then you may be wondering what's new or different in the PRU ICSSG. The table on this slide shows at a high level the new hardware features, shown in red, and the upgraded features, shown in blue. The subsequent PRU-ICSSG training modules will discuss the specific details about these enhancements in greater depth. Now that we have a basic understanding of the PRU-ICSSG hardware features, let's take a look at examples of new applications that this subsystem enables. We'll start by looking at the original PRU-ICSS sample applications shown on this slide. Here we see a number of applications in the realm of industrial networking, feedback interfaces and motor control, as well as general purpose applications. The new hardware features on the PRU-ICSSG allow for a number of new applications. Within the area of industrial networking, we can now achieve gigabit speeds. In the area of feedback interfaces and motor control, the PRU-ICSSG now integrates a hardware PWM. Additionally, in the area of general purpose applications, we can now do preemptible software execution using the task manager that was previously mentioned. One thing that is important to note is that this is not an exhaustive list of the type of applications you can do on the PRU-ICSS or PRU-ICSSG. This concludes the PRU-ICSSG overview. For more information and to get started with the PRU-ICSSG, please visit the link shown on this slide. For PRU-ICSSG support, visit the E2E forums.